race, Joe?
Well, I enjoyed it. I thought it was a very good race. It seemed like it was pretty competitive. I didn't know who was going to win till right to the last minute, it seemed like to me.
Did you do any special training?
Well, this winter I trained two different teams, where I didn't do that last year. This time I trained one for just for this Iditarod and one for racing, but it's too much of a hassle for one guy to train both. So either I've got to start training just for this or start training just for sprint racing. I don't know, I've got to try to make up my mind which I want to do.
Find it pretty competitive racing with your dad?
Oh yeah, he's a good competitor. He's out to win, just like anybody else.
What made you decide to get started racing in the Iditarod in the first place?
Oh, I don't know. It's just kind of new. It's, you know, it's kind of a challenge to see how a man can, you know, against the weather conditions and stuff like that, you know.
How much did you win by coming in third?
How much did money did I make or what? I think $7,500.
Think it's worth it?
Oh, yeah. It's worth it.
You gonna do it again next year?
Well, I don't know for sure. If I don't run, I might let my dad have mine, and him and I will put a team together for it. Let him run them.
Is he gonna run next year for sure?
Oh, he'll run for sure, whether he gets my dogs or not. Yeah, he really likes this kind of racing, you know. It brings a lot of the old-time mushers back, too. It's not like, you see a lot of guys here that wouldn't even be interested in running sprint races, so it's good for dog mushing, and I really enjoy it. It's just that it takes a lot of time to train a team for this.
I notice there's a lot of older guys racing in the Iditarod that don't race.
Old and tough, you know. Wise old men. Yeah, they're pretty tough.
Great. Thanks a lot, Joey.
Okay.